This is a video about the way how to construct a face for this wire model vessel. There were a quest in the forum, and the first try was to make a sweep. And if you make a sweep, you have some problems. You have always problems if you have a sweep where the end edges come together. It's hard to get the interpolation managed, so there should be another way. And what I have done in the NURBS workbench, I need special curves. So the first step, what I made was I used the curves workbench, and there is a feature join edges into B-spline curves, and this was the first step, and so I got this join curves. So if we look at the curves, we see there are in each of these curves, I hide the other one, we have here a compound of multiple curves, and this is not so good. So the next step, what I need is to create from these curves objects which consist only of one curve. So when I click here, I see this is exactly one curve. Here the same, and so on. And what I have done is I have here now three single curves for the meridians, and I have three curves for the ribs of the boat this way. There is still one problem. The problem is that all of these curves have a different number of poles and knots. So it's hard to find an algorithm which merges this data in a way what we can control and what to get what we want to get. So the next step, what I can do with these curves, is I have in the NURBS workbench a method create bearing. This is a special Bézier curve, and I hide them. And we look at the bearings. They are here. It looks still the same. It's the same like the original. When I hide and show it, there is no difference. But now I have another structure. First thing what I have is when I look at such an object, I have here 10 poles. I have here 10 poles. Always the same number of poles. So it's now easy to combine them. And how can I create such an object? If I look at the structure of this object, I see I have a source where the data come from. I have an interval and a start of this curve. And I also can insert extra knots. These knots are here at position .05 and .1, that means here. And I have here another example. In this case, the extra knots are here at position 8 and 9. So if I insert the knots in different positions, the result will differ too. And this is the way how I can configure the curves to get a face I want. So with these bearings, now the next way is that I have to select four of them, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and now with four of these objects I can create the product of these faces. This is the result, and now I have to change the directions. This is always a little bit to play something I go into the false direction. So, and at the end I have a face which is bounded by the four curves and looks like this. Okay, I have done this for all these areas here, and the results are these faces. And what we see is that we get different results on different areas. This depends on the knots we have inserted. We have inserted knots here, so this means we get here in this area a stronger corner, and here we have a long way from this curve to the end. And on this side I think we have something what we want. It's smooth enough. We can look at the map models, and here we see the difference. We see here this is a good grid, it's good balanced, and here on this side we have some extreme areas. We have here a very dense grid, and here we have the grid moved in this direction, and of course we do not like this and this solution, we like the other solution. To get different solutions we have to change here in the sketch this value, this extra knots. Okay, now we have the solution in this way. We can look at the B grid in the background. This is our model of the control points, of the main control points, and we see we have different solutions on this side and here, and we the impact is are different phases. So when we change a knot in our curve, then this point will move along this curve and so on, and so we will get another face. Okay, let's look at the face with the zebra tool, and we see we have still here something to clean up. This we have algorithms to bring a tangent constraint between these areas. This is not a problem. Here we have this hard break, we see this here. So what we can do, we can say we hide it, I only showed this one. We now can say we want to select this face and do a polish, and now we have another result. And when we look at this result, I shut this off, we see there is no more this heartbreak here. That means the surface now is smoothed. Okay, I have this prepared once more, and I have also a map here from the smoothed surface, and we can compare this both models. Right, this this one has this map, and this one has this map. So we can compare the two maps. I change the color of one of this map. And so we see here the difference of these two maps. There is no big difference, but here in this area and here it is smoothed. And of course if I smooth always, I have also a small movement of the control curves, but so I can get this area. So, and so we have the complete result.